Hey, good morning, everybody. Jim Benton here from Chorus. Thanks for joining us today. I'm joined by Rock Versace, CRO of Troops.ai. Hey, Rock, how are you today?
I'm good, Jim. Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for kicking off the Thursday. This is fun to get together when we're all remote.
It is, and you're letting me miss my leadership daily stand-up, so appreciate that one also.
Is that a new daily since the work?
It is. It is for since COVID, for sure. Yeah.
You're here in the Bay Area. Are you up in the city?
I am in the city. Yeah. Most of our guys are in New York, and we have about six of us out here.
Gotcha. How just from a work at home standpoint, how are you holding up, and just any surprises, any changes?
Gosh, how am I holding up? I think it's last week it started to get a little old. But my wife is here working from home. Both my boys are in high school, so they don't really want to come out of their bedroom anyway. So from that perspective, it's really easy compared to, like, I can't imagine if they had been 4 and 7 at this point in time, or if we had to homeschool. So I think that overall we're really lucky. It's just lucky timing.
Yeah. You know, yeah. I heard from many calls last week, we had a big group session with the group I was part of, this fatigue last week. You know, as you just mentioned, last week started to get old. Why do you think that is? What changed last week, or what is it that we're starting to feel right now?
I for me personally, last week it was just maybe I wasn't feeling that great. Maybe it's allergy season or whatever, or it's the grind, or, you know, maybe it was just actually fatigue from, I think that a lot of us have worked really extra hard and in an extra stressful time over the last 6 weeks, and maybe it just caught up to us. Yeah. Like, and then also for me, it's like, I'm not always out all the time, but I do like to travel for work. But I also like to have things to look forward to, concerts or trips or things like that. And it's like, you know, instead of looking forward to things, we're just canceling things left and right. Cancel, not going to that wedding, not doing this, not doing that. So I think it was kind of a combination of all of the energy and emotional spend that we did since COVID started with the, geez, what do I, you know, what's out in the horizon that I'm excited about, looking forward to? My son's not having his 8th grade graduation. My older son's not having the prom. So, yeah. You know, it's just a little bit of that, I think.
I appreciate you sharing. I feel like we're all going through it. And I think as we all figured out, just the recharge. I mean, we are expending incredible amounts of energy and productivity up from a pure work standpoint, but the recharge, both the human side of just connecting and having a beer or lunches together. Yeah. I don't know if we're getting the recharge that we're used to getting.
Well, you look pretty charged. What are you doing?
I got a nice good cup of coffee right here, and it's coming in strong.
All right, good.
Hey, one more thing before we jump right into the data. I noticed that at Troops, you launched a work at home pack, which is something a lot of companies had either explored or talked about, and you have it. It's right there on your homepage. I'm curious if you could share initial thoughts. How's that worked?
So fundamentally, we've just, you know, it's funny. The things that we do since COVID have really made me look at myself and go, why did it take COVID? Why did it take a global pandemic to try something new? And I really want to take it back to, you know, I joined Troops almost a year ago. And when you come in and you're the CRO and you're coming into a venture funded company, you've got this revenue target that the board wants you to hit. And so the idea of doing a 60-day free trial out of the gate isn't something that you even want to ponder, because you're like, well, how am I going to hit my number? Yeah. But in reality, we're selling something, you know, I want to say newer. I don't mean that in a cool way. I mean it in a just an unknown way. And what we've learned over the last 12 months is we have this kind of bubble of companies who use Troops and are pretty happy with it. And then they'll leave and bring us to somewhere else. And we're like, God, how do we break out of that bubble?
Yeah.
Because it seems very insular. And so really when COVID hit, it kind of gave us the kick in the butt we needed to try something that, frankly, I wish we'd have done 6 or 8 months earlier. And that has absolutely been helpful, because I think we have a lot of prospects who have a difficult time articulating the value because it is newer. And now that we're giving them the 60 days, we're buying them the time to let people see it and see for themselves. So it's been, you know, obviously it's 60 days. We're only 30 days in, so nothing's closed.
Yeah.
Right. In that program. But it's definitely been something that we've we've had some fun with and success with. And the thing I'd say there is that one of the main things is going back into dead lost opportunities, which is, you know, tried and true SaaS rep motion, but going into those companies and then giving us the response back of, oh my gosh, this is great. Thank you. This is what we wanted to try. That was great. And then we also have learned that we need to be more prescriptive. We hear this a lot. You need to be more, tell us what we should be doing, right? And so that's what we did with the remote pack, was we said, let's pull together six of the top workflows that people use kind of from a remote perspective, and let's implement that for you. And we actually did a massive training where everybody in the commercial team, BDRs, AEs, frontline managers, all had to learn how to do the implementation.
Interesting.
And so it really made people get deeper into the product, which was really helpful too. So yeah, it's something that I'm happy we did it now, but I'm also kind of kicking myself that we didn't do it a long time ago.
One last question on that. I mean, when you look at what in another 30 days, when you hit the 60-day mark, what kind of impact ballpark on a pipeline do you think this could have? Is it multitudes or, you know, an improvement?
It's so of the ones we have in, the team's saying that they think that there's a 50% chance, a 50% close rate opportunity.
Yep.
And you know, we're still trying to figure it out. We don't know which edition, right? They're starting with the remote pack, and we don't know which edition, the version they'll want to go to, but it's actually opening a lot of conversations into more functionality that they might want. So, but I do think it's going to have a major incremental result.
Yeah. Well, look, I think it's impressive. You did it. It's out there. And what a great time if you're going to give 60 days free. This is the cycle to do it. We've heard that from many others on this brief.
You know what? Just, yeah, one note on that is a lot of our prospects are doing something similar. Mm-hmm. And so that also makes a nice connection. Like we're both doing the same kinds of things. It's something to bond around.
That's what initially, you know, when we were putting the briefing together, it was just about how do we all help each other? What can we do? We have this beautiful Zoom native integration, and we were being much more flexible about helping people take advantage of it and staying close to their teams. And so I think it's terrific. The data, Rock, that we have here is our most updated data looking at meeting activity across different segments. And so we'll look at this today across a couple different segments as well as by geography, and then we'll dig into a few other metrics. Overall, you know, from a pre-COVID level, we're still down 7% in most segments, but up 7% week over week. The sales tech space, and I've used Troops in many companies, wonderful product, and from
a sales
tech company, but we're up. I mean, sales tech is up 14% in terms of meeting volume since pre-COVID, 17% week over week. And then you can see in the other categories here, you know, collaboration, project management, has been up both, you know, week over week as well as, you know, pre-COVID significantly. Does that line up with what you're seeing as in your space?
The way you're breaking down these segments, certainly, right? The second and third, sales tech and collaboration and training, actually all three of those are definitely segments that I think it's pretty obvious which segments you want to go after. We did have a couple of big prospects that sold to restaurants and sold event management type stuff that are just gone, right, for the short term, hopefully.
Yep.
But yeah, I'd say that I noticed this is tech. This is all meetings, not just first meetings, I believe. And I think that this is, so there's a couple variables that I think are playing into our increase. I don't know about everybody else's, but one of them is that because of the 60-day free trial, we're getting a lot more conversations. So that's not an apples to apples before COVID and after. And so the offer is so much more apparent that that's driving more conversations. And then secondly, I'd say that we are having many more conversations with active prospects. Because they're active, they're making a choice that, hey, we really believe in what Troops is doing. Otherwise, I mean, there's a lot of reasons to say no in this time, right? Sure. And as a result, we're actually doubling or actually like quadrupling down. Like we're going in and saying, we would love to talk to your frontline managers, your frontline ICs. And those are all meetings where we gather up and we try to parlay the idea that we are an extension of your sales ops team when you probably don't have a lot of extra time. And we can go do these interviews for you and gather a lot of requirements on visibility and what people need at all parts of your business. And that just drives a lot of meetings, right? And we're doing a lot better consultative strategic selling as a result. But it's not necessarily always, so there's two variables there, right? More meetings with the companies that you're working with and more meetings because we're offering something that's better than what we were offering before.
Have you, from a driving urgency standpoint, and I understand you're doing free trials for some of the additions, but are you able to drive urgency on the larger companies right now? Have you figured out any tactics or approaches to find that common ground?
You know, I haven't. I've thought about it. And I think that, again, like I love your space. I think that the recording and the intelligence you do around it is really important, and companies should have that. And I think you also have a situation where, like, use cases. Like we had a marketing guy on our team go through and do the analysis of the calls from the fourth quarter all the way through today to figure out what the reps were talking about and how it shifted. That's an incredible use case, but it's not one that I would think that, you know, Chorus would lead with. But that was really helpful for us to see how reps have stopped talking about some of the stuff they've talked about in the fourth quarter and talk about it now. But back to urgency, because we're more evangelical and because you don't wake up and go, hey, the troops equivalent we have is coming up for renewal on May 15th, we have to replace it. We don't have that natural compelling event. What we try to tie our compelling events to or try to tie troops to is a bigger initiative. Do you have an initiative to increase rep productivity? Do you have an interest increase rep performance and quota attainment? Do you have an initiative to increase your data quality and visibility so executives can make better decisions? And those, if we find those projects are still going on, then we have a good shot. But it's really not us driving the compelling event, it's us sliding into one.
I think it's fair. I think the idea of just analyzing the past, what worked and how it changed and what we're doing now and how do we then clone that for others is key. I wanted to share with you also just the other half of the segment data. And there are definitely categories that have been very significantly impacted, more so than others. You know, the HR tech, media, even the data BI from pre-COVID, though media and tech is bouncing back significantly week over week. And I think we're seeing it in some of the earnings as you look at what Facebook and Google are saying about
stabilizing.
Yeah. But you've been through, you and I were just talking about, we've been through 2001, yeah. We've been through 2008, you know, cycle. Yeah. Any learnings from you've seen it all. For those that are going through sectors hit harder, any learnings from your past back at EchoSign and BroadVision of what to do when working through these tough periods?
Well, you heard Benioff was like, we backed off a little bit after 2008. We're not going to let that happen again. I was talking to some guys that invest, and they had all kinds of great graphs that showed after a bad thing happens that the market recovers actually pretty well. And you know, you were here for the .com bust, and I would say that one was more painful for the tech industry than the financial services bust. Because it was just so acutely tied to our industry, whereas the financial services, really, tech companies, as long as you had the money to continue on, you just kind of buckle mm-hmm. down a little bit, you shed some costs, which, you know, suck, but you do it, and then it bounced back pretty quickly. I don't think this is going to be something we look back on and don't bounce and see we didn't bounce back. I think it's going to be more like we should have been more confident. And actually, I think that the market, the stock market is showing that as well. I think the stock market, it feels like people have learned, like, hey, we're not going to let this thing, you know, scare us down to 6,800, which is what happened in the financial crisis at the Dow, right? And now it's at 25. So you look at these tech stock prices, and they're at all time highs in some of these cases. And it's really hard to humanity-wise, look at the unemployment go to 28 million and then at the same time see these companies hit all-time highs. So I think that the market and the smart money is out there saying, hey, we're going to get through this. And the companies that don't chicken out are going to be fine.
Yeah. We've heard it in the briefings, either the, accelerating in the curves. And I think you're right. It is tricky. You look at the market, you look at unemployment today in the journal. I mean, it hit 30.3, consumer spending down 7.5%, the greatest drop since 1959 when they started tracking this. That said, on a positive, you look at this data right here. This is our most recent data of meeting volume across the different geographic segments. And we've looked at this for four straight weeks and it's been down. I mean, it's matched what you see in the news. So when Boston was getting really significantly impacted, and they know they're still dealing with COVID significantly, but it's bounced back 17.5%. And we're hearing that from, companies that have sales teams out there, Toronto up 22, Austin 15. So across the board, this was a week where we saw, sales and the overall productivity jump up, which I think is incredibly encouraging.
Yeah. What do you think about, the fact that the dot-com in the 2008, those were entire sectors that bottomed out because of really fundamental problems with those industries at the time. Whereas with COVID, there was nothing that was a fundamental problem that was the cause of this. Yeah. And maybe that's part of it. Right. So there wasn't,
Yeah,
we'll see what happens, right? But I think that might be one of the differences.
I think that in this one, we expect that as we see, 3.8 people go unemployed, we might see very quickly that 3.8 million people just entered the workforce. That's the hope. And we just don't know. I think that the one part where the data is tricky is that although we show meeting productivities somewhat even, it isn't in all sectors. Some are up and some are down dramatically. And that delta is pretty significant. So I think that we are seeing, just like we're seeing the big tech companies get through this well, as they're well positioned, we know it, we all know the brick and mortar type companies are really, and the restaurants are hit in such a significant way. So that's the one challenge in the data, is just how quickly do people get back to some of the old habits, even just business travel you and I were talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Do we think that jumping on a plane for key meetings, will bounce back 100%? Of course, something will bounce back, but do you expect to be out in the field as much?
Well, I don't expect to be out in the field much over the next year. I think before there's a vaccine, I think there's going to be a lot of companies that are like, I get that you want to meet us in person, but why don't we don't want your germs coming into our offices. I also think, the laptop workers like us, there's not going to be a rush to go back to the office, right? We're not the ones that are really impacted the way others are. And so we can continue to work from wherever we are. And I think it's going to be the buyers that are going to be more reticent to have you come see them face to face. I think that the big event kind of thing is going to be down, obviously going to be down quite a bit. So how do you do more field marketing things? I think that could be really interesting. Maybe you get people out at a restaurant where it's, there's rules and it's safe and you can do some meeting that way. I think that the travel to walking into offices is going to be impacted for at least the next year, depending on viruses. And then maybe there's this move where people feel like, hey, we're able to do this remotely. Why do we have to go face to face? But as we were talking about before, there has been a trend over the last several years to get more face to face with buyers, and it's impacted close rates quite a bit. And I don't think the humanity part of it is not going to go away. And perhaps it comes back even stronger because people have missed this so much. Like I said to my family the other day, it's like, I love the three of you a lot, but it's okay if you're sick of seeing me and I'm sick of seeing you, because it's just the four of us for 8 weeks.
That's what I'm expecting. If I were predicting the bounce back, I don't think we're going to go fly out to meet people and do PowerPoint in a conference room. I think that Zoom has clearly shown that we can aggregate and do that. I mean, things will bounce back. But I do think the recharge and how we go do experiential events with our buyers, concerts, outdoor events, whatever it might be, Vegas might boom, but ways to say, look, let's get together in person. Let's talk about building up trust and relationships and maybe do it outside of the office. Yeah. That I think we're hungry to do. And if our companies are funding those experiences, which they should to build these relationships, I'll be raising my hand as well on that.
So it'll be really nice. Totally. Yeah.
couple more questions for you, Rock. Let me just pull up real quick on the what we're seeing on cold calls and kind of connect rates. And, you know, as a business, is Troops, I know you've launched the free trial, but have you typically been a company that does a lot of outbound and, you know, cold calling?
Yeah, so we averaged about 90 cold calls a day by BDR. Okay. And I feel like that's really high. But to be honest with you, the results were not great. And we are not doing anywhere near as much calling now. It's a lot more warm calling than cold calling. I used to use a product called Connect and Sell where they would get you four or five connects within an hour. And it's very expensive, right? You need to do the ROI well, but it does work better if you've got a list that you're already somewhat warm with than pure cold. So the pure cold calling is definitely, we're not doing as much of it anymore, and a lot more personal outreach and targeted outreach. And I think, you know, will that scale beyond COVID when we, you know, really want to expand faster? I don't know. But right now, our cold calling is definitely way down.
It's interesting. So everybody's cold calling is way down.
Yeah, is that right? That's interesting.
We're seeing that across the board. So if I just go back, we're down 34%, you know, since March. And look, people are at home. It's trickier to connect with people over the phone. Clearly, we need cell phone data. But connect rates, by the way, are up. So when we do engage people, people are answering their phone. What we've heard from others is that people are, you know, they're open to talking to people right now. That they're more inclined to want to answer a call and connect and be real. I think the authenticity of these calls has changed. But what's interesting on the first meeting data is that it's up. And we just pulled this in the most recent week. It's up again. So 33% of the time that AEs are spending is now on first meetings. It's the highest we've seen since the beginning of the year. So somehow, with cold calls down, you're right, we're seeing through email and LinkedIn and other forms that we're able to get out there and meet and connect with new customers. So we're seeing brand new behaviors out in the marketplace.
So I think this is interesting too. Do you think, I think that we were doing a lot of calls as we headed into COVID and we were getting higher connect rates, but they were they weren't very fruitful, right? But people were open to talking, and we did learn a bit about, you know, this initiative or that initiative, but it didn't lead to as much. And I'm curious also, the increase in time for the first, or the increase in the first calls, this is definitely not quantitative by any stretch, but I do get a feel that people aren't rushing you off the phone. Buyers aren't rushing you off the phone during meetings like they used to. I think people have just a little bit more time. And again, this is just completely anecdotal, but it just feels like, again, if they're talking to you to begin with in this environment, they're a little bit more inclined to want to dig in.
Yeah.
And so I think that we're getting longer, more meaningful conversations as a result of, I mean, everybody's more focused now. And if they don't always choose to focus on Troops by any stretch, but the percent that we do, they're focused. Right. And they're spending more time with us, or they're not looking at five different things. They're looking at one, and they're saying, well, how can we do this thing right and make it work? Again, it's not everybody by any stretch, but the ones that do, it's nice.
Rock, from an emailing standpoint and a messaging standpoint, have you dramatically changed what you would say, or is it similar to what we were saying to folks, you know, before COVID?
We tried not to over-index and do the COVID alarm stuff. And we do have a remote work performance pack, and we are kind of built for remote anyway, because it's alerting. A lot of stuff happens in your database, in your CRM, that nobody knows about. So it's the alerting and letting people know what's happening that is a lot of our value prop. And so for us, I wanted to make sure that we didn't over-index on remote to make people think, well, once remote's over, we don't need Troops anymore. And so we really didn't go too heavy into the, oh, the world has changed in COVID, and now that's why Troops is good. We went into it and saying, hey, here's an area of our product that we think will be especially helpful for you today.
Love it. I love it. Well, hey, Rock, thank you so much for kicking off today. Fun to spend the Thursday with you.
Yeah, it's a nice way to kick off a morning. You're so upbeat. I like it. Thanks, Jim. Yeah.
Well, I look forward to meeting in person when things reopened. And thanks again. Really appreciate it.
Absolutely. Thanks for your time, Jim. I appreciate the interest.
Cheers.
Bye-bye.